Hello and welcome back to the Beautiful Things channel. It's been a while since I last did a video for you, but I thought I would do a little video to explain the tweaks and the changes that I make to the Kielo Wrap dress, which is what I'm wearing today. This is a new dress. I've only just made it, so you haven't seen it before. You might have seen some pictures on Instagram, but it's made with lovely cotton jersey from Pink Scissors. I absolutely love Suzanne's fabrics. She always buys really good quality when she gets her jersey in, and you can guarantee that it's going to be beautiful to work with. So I love the Kielo Wrap dress. I've made quite a few already. I will link up here my how to wear a Kielo dress video, because there are loads of different ways that you can wear it. But it is incredibly flattering, whatever your shape and whatever your size. It really does cinch everything in and it looks amazing. So don't panic if you're a little on the larger size or you've got a different body shape to everybody else. Give it a go. I guarantee you, you'll really enjoy it, because there are so many different ways that you can wear it. So my first thing to say is fabric choice. It really doesn't matter what kind of jersey fabric you use, or stretch fabric that you use, but the pattern is designed for stretch fabrics. There are people that have made it before with a woven fabric and they've put an opening or a fastening into the back. I personally haven't tried it. I have no intention of trying it. So I prefer to always use the fabric that is recommended for a pattern. But if you want to pick a stretch fabric, you really can get away with any type of stretch fabric. This one, as I say, is made with a cotton jersey, which is 95% cotton and 5% spandex or lycra. And it's really quite firm. It hangs quite nicely. It's kind of what I would call a medium weight. It's not as heavy as a Ponderoma, but I have used Ponderoma to make a Kielo before. But that is obviously a more wintry dress because it is heavier weight jersey. My absolute favourite thing to make a Kielo Wrap dress in is a viscose jersey, because it can be screwed up in the suitcase and it pops back out when you come home from your holiday or when you get to your holiday location, and it is beautifully crease free. It's really lightweight, it's incredibly flattering, and it can look really fantastic. I'll put a picture up here of Elspeth when she was at Maddie's wedding last year. She made this Kielo Wrap dress in a viscose jersey, and I'm sure you'll agree it looks absolutely beautiful. I've yet to make one in a viscose jersey myself, simply because I haven't found one that I really, really like, but I have made plenty in what I like to call really cheap and cheerful nasty t-shirt jersey, because that works brilliantly too. If it's really drapey and really flimsy, but as long as it's got some stretch, it looks great. So I made a Christmas Kielo Wrap dress. Again, I'll pop a picture up here of that one. This fabric was bought from Birmingham Rag Market for 50p a metre, and it was almost see-through, but it was really good. It made a great dress that fitted really well, and because it was so lightweight, it had a really nice drape to it. I've also made a Kielo in something in between this and the cheapy jersey, with some lightweight t-shirt jersey that I bought in Arizona. I wear this all the time, and I've also made a top as well that you've probably seen before. I'll pop the picture up here. This is a really comfortable one. It's really lightweight, and it's really cool for the summer months. So honestly, any jersey goes for the Kielo Wrap dress. So with regards to the pattern itself, you can buy a printed pattern from Named Clothing. I will link it down below. It is an affiliate link, just saying. And by all means, you can purchase it either from Finland directly from Named, or from an alternative supplier like I've linked below. If you do, however, buy the PDF version from Named direct from their website, do not attempt to print it out and stick it together yourself. I've tried, Maddie's tried, Elspeth's tried, numerous people who've come to BTHQ have tried, and it never seems to line itself up very well. It's really fiddly, it uses endless pages of paper because it's a really big, long pattern. Buy yourself the PDF, get the A0 copy and send it off to somebody like NetPrinter or a similar printing service to get it printed and sent back to you. You can then trace it off if you want to, or you can cut it directly out of the paper. It's entirely up to you. The next thing I like to do, as you'll see, is I've added bands to my armholes and my neckline. The pattern is not designed to have armbands. You're simply supposed to turn it under and stitch it down. However, I don't think that's a very neat, very nice finish. And under the arms, if you would imagine, there is no band here. By the time I turned that under, I would have quite a bit of bra or side boob on show. Nobody likes too much side boob. So armbands and a neck band are a really nice finishing touch. What they also do is slightly widen the shoulder. So you can see without bands, if I turn this under, my shoulder strap would be very narrow and it would only just about cover my bra strap. But by adding the bands, I've added some length to the shoulders, and I know I much prefer to have all my straps and everything covered up. So how do I do those bands? It's really simple. I make the dress, first of all. I get it pretty much finished. And then I measure the circumference of the full neckline. And then I take 90% of that measurement. And I do the same with the armholes. So I measure the whole circumference of the armhole and I take 90% of that measurement. I don't worry about seam allowance, I just go with 90%, and I cut my strips of fabric 1.5 inches wide. And then I turn them into a complete loop by joining the short ends right sides together. And then I follow my neckband tutorial for both the neckband and the armbands. I will link it up here and I will also link it down below. But it is my foolproof way of putting in bands nice and neatly on the sewing machine, on the overlocker, or with a combination of both. So with regards to the overlocker, can you use an overlocker to make a kielo wrap dress? Yes and no. There are certain parts that you can do, certain parts that you can't do. The main bit that you can't do is the seam along the back, because you only sew some way down before having to press it open to create the vent at the back. And you need that vent because otherwise you're going to be walking like a penguin. So what I tend to do is sew that bit on my sewing machine, and then everything else I sew on my overlocker. Now, one final tip for you when it comes to sewing up from under the arm down to the pointy bits. There is a little notch under the arm here, and you're supposed to stitch from that notch so that you can allow to turn the fabric in. But because we're adding bands and we're not turning the fabric in, you need to make sure that you stitch from the very edge of the fabric, just above the notch, down to your seam allowance, and then down. Otherwise, what's going to happen is when you add your bands to your armhole, you will end up with a little teeny tiny hole just here, and nobody wants holes in their armpits. So I hope that's helped you. A few top tips for sewing a really super kielo wrap dress. Oh, finally, yes, you can shorten the kielo wrap dress. What you need to bear in mind though is it doesn't have a dead straight bottom, because when you tie it up and you bring up those edges and wrap them around you, it pulls up the sides. So what I would highly recommend doing is making a full length kielo, trying it on, working out how much you want to chop off, and then laying it out nice and flat on your cutting table or on your cutting mat. You'll see that there is ever such a slight curve to the bottom, and when you remove however many inches you want to remove, just match that curve along the bottom edge, and it will mean that when you tie your dress up, it won't have a weird higgledy-piggledy hem. So the best of luck to you if you're making a kielo wrap dress. If you do put it on social media, please tag me if you've used any of my tips. Share this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel, why not? Hit the subscribe button now, please. Thank you very much, and I will see you all in another video really soon. Thanks for watching.